Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and this is Mukta here. Today I have this gorgeous Christmas mixed media artwork to share with you all, and this project is 12 inch by 8 inch in size, so that is a pretty big project. And everything you see is made from scratch, including the flowers and the backdrop as well as those trees and other stuff. So without much ado, let's get started. I started by drawing and fussy cutting my own trees. I made three of these trees and I fussy cut them out using scissors. It was a hectic work, but I really am happy the way these trees have turned out. Apart from this, you can see that I'm using this chipboard element. It is like a window and a brick wall, and I cut out those window on my own. It is from ItysBitsy, and the frame that you see below is made from MDF, and it is almost like a floral Christmassy wreath. So I'm going to coat all of these elements with heavy white gesso. This is from Finnbair, and I had to add two coats of gesso to the frame because it is made from MDF. On the rest of them, I just added one coat of heavy white gesso. So after everything was done, I thoroughly dried them because I did not want the gesso to be wet, because we were going to now add some more textures and more colors on this. At this particular time, I was very happy, at least you know, that this is a project that I have been thinking to do for a very long time, and I was just happy that finally I'm going to do it. So for adhering all these elements, now it is time to build my layout, and to do that I'm going to use 3D matte gel. You can use any other gel that you have, but I'm using 3D matte gel from Finnbair because that is what I had on my you know, in hand. So you can use anything that you're comfortable with. You can even use an adhesive or a hot glue gun or anything that you really want. So I'm just using 3D matte gel because I wanted this to be very strongly adhered, and I did not want it to, you know, fall apart because I was going to gift it to my friend. So here you can see that I am arranging all the elements together. I was not sure at this point whether I wanted to add the wreath on the left or on the upper side, but you know, I'm happy the way that it has turned out to be. So this entire project from start till the very end has taken me 6 to 8 hours to make, and I have really sped up the video and edited and cropped a little in a little places because the video is getting too long, and even now after all the effort it is still around 19 minutes. So I really hope that you don't get bored and you enjoy the entire creativity process. I did not want to cut anything out, so I've left as much as I could. So now I'm going to add a little more texture to my trees, and for that I'm going to use some texture sand with mixed media stones, and I have mixed it with heavy white gesso. Heavy white gesso is a good you know, it's almost like a sticky glue that you can use. So you can either mix it with matte gel or your gel medium or with heavy gesso. So I'm just mixing it with my gesso, and I'm going to coat both of the trees properly to add some more texture because I was going to, you know, create this effect of snow on that. I dried it thoroughly, and then I am now adding the next element, which is the brick window frame, and then the other tree. Now the whole idea is to create a layout where the trees, larger trees, are the outside, and then the window, and the smaller tree is the actual Christmas tree, which is on the inside. So after this was done, I left it to dry thoroughly, and I came back with my molds. Now these are molds from Prima. One is Stars and Moons mold by Finnbair, and the other is Decor Molds Numerals by Redesign. I took these two molds, and then using some air drying clay, I got few of my clay pieces. I am using the moon, few stars, and the Roman numerals. I coated it all with heavy gesso and dried it. Now to give my you know, composition a backdrop, I came back with two numbers, 25. Now these again are cut by myself, and I have used sunboard and chipboard in combination to give it a little thickness as well as little sturdiness. So I'm going to attach my entire composition to the number 25 using some 3D matte gel again. Now I was not sure at this point if that 25 will be visible or not now, but at the very end when I'm looking at all of it together, it just looks so nice. So this was a risk that I took, and I think it paid off really well. So I left this to dry completely, and then I came back with cheesecloth, and I started adding cheesecloth in a few random places on the number 25. Now before I added the cheesecloth, I had also completely coated my number with heavy gesso, so it is already primed and ready. So I'm adding the cheesecloth using some gel medium. I dried it thoroughly and then I came back with a stencil, which is called as Manuscript from Finnbair, and I added a little texture on the number 25 as well in a few random places. Now it was all plain, and that is the reason why I'm adding a texture in few places. And also I wanted to give this effect of a snowy night, so all this texture would help me to bring that nice effect. Once all the stenciling was done, I got up and I cleaned my stencil and my spatula, because that is really important. And then I came back and started drying my entire composition. So it was very important that I dried it thoroughly, because now I was going to add all the clay pieces to my composition. So there was no arrangement for this. I just wanted to add the moon at the very top of the tree, and then I sprinkled few of the stars here and there, and then on the left hand side I decided to add the Roman number 12. I don't know if it's going to be really visible. At this point of time I was not sure whether it was going to be visible or not, but I wanted to put the number 12 on the left. And now I'm attaching the window that we had cut out initially to complete my composition. I set everything aside to dry thoroughly, and now I came back with my Lindy's colors, and it was time to play with some colors. On the very top, I'm using three squirts, Lindy squirts. One is hockey puck black, and then Banff blue, and the third one is polite people's purple. Now these are some new products from Lindy's, and they are really cool and really easy to use. So these three I used at the very top, and I did one layer. Rinsed it with a little water and then dried it. But then I was not completely happy with the way it was looking, and I wanted it to be a little more intense. So that is why I did another layer of the same three colors, and then I dried it. And then it looks a little more rich and darker, and gives this entire thing like you're looking at a starry night or a galaxy or a, you know, I don't know. I was very happy and really excited about the way it had turned out. And these quartz have these amazing mica in them. So all of them have got different color of mica. Like the blue has got a blue mica, and the purple has got golden mica, and the black has got a greenish gold mica. So once it dries, it really has this amazing shine to it. So on the lower part, I have used again the Banff blue squirt, and then I have used Delphinium turquoise blue in the spray form, and then I have also used a little bit of Frenchy's pink Pouf, which is a kind of a violet, and then the last one is Gag Me with a Spoon gray, which has this amazing silver mica in that. So these were the colors that I used to color my 25. Now for the trees, I'm using a few squirts as well as a few sprays. On the larger tree, I am using Lucky Shamrock Green, and along with that I'm using Edelweiss Moss Green. And for the medium sized tree, I am using Emerald A, which is a Lindy squirt, and Aloha Avocado, along with a little Gag Me with a Spoon gray. So again, it was the same thing. I first initially did one coat of it, and I was slowly adding a little. You can see that I'm using the tip of the sprayer to do that, because there were little spots here and there, and I did not want that brick wall to get covered with green. So that is why I was really careful while I was applying, and that is also the reason why I did not spray, because then it would just go on the number 25, and I did not want that to happen. So I slowly added the color here and there, and I spritzed it with a little water, and then dried it completely. And then again I came back with the same colors and did a second coat. In this form you can build your colors. If you just keep adding color over color and then keep spraying it with water and not drying it, it's just going to mix all together, and then you will not get that intense color that you're looking for. So that is what I do. If I want it to be a little more intense, I add a little color, spritz it with a little water, and then dry it thoroughly. So you can see that I'm adding a little bit of that gray, and that has this, you know, Lindy's colors are amazing. And if you have not tried, then I recommend that you should go and buy them, because they have this amazing mica shine, and those colors are really vibrant and so pretty, and such a varied range of colors. I must say that at least the squirts are my new favorite, and I use them almost on all my projects. For the smallest tree in the front, I have used Poutine gold, which is a squirt, along with Edelweiss moss green, which is a spray, and again I did two coats and then I colored my front tree. And now for the number 12, I have used two colors again. One is Hockey Puck Black, which is a squirt, and along with that I have used Frenchy's Pink Pouf. So I have used these two colors in combination to again give it a little more darker color, so that number 12 stands out. And 12 actually is something that I associate with Christmas because of the midnight mass that everybody goes to, so that is why I was very keen on adding that number 12. Now I've used the same violet to color my wreath as well, along with a little bit of shades of I think blue as well in that, blue and silvers, silver and a little violet. And I wanted to get all the composition together and build my entire scene. So then I came back with the again same two colors, and then I did a second coat of them to get a more vibrant and intense color, and then I dried it all thoroughly. After it was all dried, I then decided to color my window frame and the brick wall, and for that I have used Hockey Puck Black along with two squirts, which are called as Maple Syrup Bronze and Beaver Tail Brown. So these are very close browns and bronze shades along with the black, and I have used these three together to create this brick wall effect. I did not want to use brown because I wanted something a little more mustard color, and that is why I have chosen these three colors. So once all of the frame was covered, I dried it all thoroughly, and then I also colored the entire edges of the number 25 and wherever white was being seen. So I made sure that it was all nicely coated and covered, so that no matter from where you are seeing the project, it looks nice and finished, and it does not look like it was made in a hurry and those little details are missed out. So I think that is something that we all should consider, and color all the areas and all the places that anything is going to be seen. So I dried it all thoroughly, and then I came back with white gesso. It was time to add a little bit of dry brushing, and this is such an important technique. You have to dry brush your project if you want to bind it all together. Right now it looks like the background is different, the trees are different, the window is different, and the numbers are different, but once I'm going to dry brush it with gesso, it all looks like it is a part of the same frame and same composition, and it looks so nice. So I was drying, I was doing this, and I was basically just highlighting all the texture that we had added, and also at the same time adding a little more gesso on one side to give this effect of snow. So here you can see that I've dry brushed everything. I also dry brushed the clay pieces, and then I came back with all the embellishments that I was going to use to dress up my artwork. Now I have used these two fussy cutting sheets from Minty Carola. One is called as Sweet Christmas, the other one is called as Home for Christmas. So these are some of the elements that I decided to fussy cut. This poinsettias and gingerbread houses and Santas and lanterns and nutcrackers and other cute stuff. Apart from this, I'm going to be using these flowers. I made this a while back using again Lindy's products, and if you want to know how I made this, there is a link above. You can click on that and it will take you to the video. And apart from these beautiful flowers and the fussy cut elements, I'm also going to use other embellishments like the holly leaves, which are die cut leaves, and the frame, and a Santa boot, and a bottle of glitter, some musical notes, moss, and sisal fibers. And I decided that I wouldn't want to use sisal fiber, though initially I did add a little, but it was making it little too crowded, and I decided to take it off. Again, to adhere my all embellishments, I'm using 3D matte gel. You can again use whatever you're comfortable with. You can use white adhesive, or you can use silicone glue or hot glue, anything that you're comfortable. I again was going to gift this canvas to my friend, and I did not want that even after some time that something starts falling off. Just to be very sure, I'm using gel medium, and Finnbair's gel medium is amazing. So that is what is my choice of glue when it comes to mixed media, and that is what I am using. So here you can see that I'm just playing around with my embellishments, and it took me at least an hour to decide what goes where. So I decided to trim the video and show you how the final layout now looks. It looks so Christmassy, right? I'm so excited, and really happy with the way it has turned out. So now I'm again, you know, dressing up the, I'm still continuing to embellish my canvas, and I'm adding a little bit of berries. These are pink berries that I made myself. It is just a pearl covered with gesso and then heat embossed and then sprinkled with glitter. So I added that in a few places. Now before I went ahead and embellished any further, I just highlighted all my clay pieces using the Finnbair metallic waxes. I have used two of them. One is old silver and the other is vintage gold. Now I use these two in combination to give this beautiful, you know, feel of twinkling stars and light and other, and the snow effect. So once this was done, I finished embellishing, and then I came back with the fun part, which is adding art stones and glitter and micro beads and sequins and all that good stuff that we all like. So I'm using the three art stones in all the three sizes, the mega, the art stones and the mini ones. And I am using a soft gloss gel from Little Body. I did not have Finnbair's, but you can use again whatever you have. So I'm using that to add a little bit of art stone here and there in random places, and I'm going to sprinkle with a little bit of glitter as well. I have used silver fine fairy dust and gold fine fairy dust, apart from that some white fairy dust and a little bit of star shaped sequins and little micro beads in silver and green, and some I think this is glass glitter by Finnbair. And this one is sterling. So I have combined all of these in random places, and then I have used them here and there to dress my entire canvas. I can't even tell you how beautiful it looks. Now I might have not shown this in the video, but then I again added a little bit of just white rainbow sprinkle, or you can also use frosting powder by Rajni Chawla, and I have added in a few places, like on the number 12 and below the, you know, on the lower part of number 25, to give this effect of snow. So I added a little bit of gel medium, and then I sprinkled the frosting powder, and then I heat set it. So it gives this really amazing thick shine, and the frosting powder starts getting white as you heat it. So it gave a shine, and it also gave this effect of snow. So here you can see I'm just still playing with the glitter, and oh my god, after I cleaned up, the glitter was just everywhere. I'm not complaining, but it was everywhere. So here I'm adding just the final touches. I had some bells, and I decided to dress my Christmas tree with a few gold bells, and I'm adding them just below the ball chain kind of stuff I used to decorate my tree. And I also added a few bells in the few random places amongst the cluster of flowers and leaves, just to give it an effect of more Christmas fun. So once all of this was done, I decided to add a little bit splatters, because it was snowing, so you need splatters. So I'm using just acrylic paint. You can again use whatever you're comfortable with. I wanted really bright splatters, and I did not want these splatters to seep inside the color. So that is why I'm using acrylic paint. So I splattered in a few places randomly using a small brush. Once this was done, I heat set it, and then I again splattered it once more. So once that all was done, I thought that it was now time to add my sentiment. And the sentiment that I chose to add is from Tim Holtz, I guess, yeah. And this one says, take the scenic route. This is such a perfect sentiment for this canvas, and that was the final thing that I did. So that brings us to the end of the video, and I really hope that you guys liked it and took some inspiration from this project. And here is an up close look at my project. It is really nice the way it has turned out, and I'm really excited to share this with you. And I hope that the tutorial was long enough, but you guys did not get bored and had fun watching this. If you have anything to ask me, then you can leave your comment below and ask me there, or you can also email me if you are not comfortable leaving it below. So thank you so much for watching again, and I wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. Bye bye.